Okay. So at least today now, can anyone say what was the last thing which we studied in the yesterday's class?
Ma'am, task analysis.
Task analysis, right, fine. So we were studying the requirement gathering phase, and under that requirement gathering phase, we were studying how the analysts, they acquire or gather the information that is needed. So one method was studying the already existing documents, then they interview the different category of users, and another way is the task analysis. That is, this entire software, it is thought as something which will provide a set of services, and each of these services is considered to be a task, and I will break my entire software into several tasks, and for each task I will try to formulate what are the different steps that are necessary in order to execute that particular task or that particular functionality. So this will help the analyst to understand the various user tasks that are needed from the software, and each user task, in order to run each task or each function, how many subtasks or how many sub functions are necessary. So the next thing which is there is the scenario analysis and form analysis. So a task can have many scenarios of operation. So the different scenarios of a task may take place when the task is invoked under different situations. So suppose a task requires three type of subtasks, it is not necessary that the three subtasks will be executed simultaneously. In different situations, maybe the different subtasks are invoked by that particular task. So for different type of scenarios of a task, the behavior of the software, that can be different. For example, suppose there is a task which we were studying, the book issue. Okay, so this book issue task of a library automation software, it may have several possible scenarios. One scenario can be that the book is issued successfully to the member and the book issue slip is printed. So book is issued and the slip is printed. This can be one situation, or rather one scenario. Another can be the book is reserved. The book is reserved and hence it cannot be issued to the member. So the book cannot be issued. Fine. Another scenario can be that the maximum number of books which can be issued to the member has already been reached, and so no more books can be issued. So maximum range of book for that particular member is reached, so no book issued, right? This can be three possible scenarios. So for various identified tasks, the possible scenarios of execution, they are identified, and the details of each scenario is identified with the user, and for each of these identified scenarios, the details regarding the system response, the exact conditions under which the scenario occurs, they are determined. So this book issue can have how many scenarios where the book issue can have positive values and can have negative values. So for this, the book issue is having positive values, for this scenario negative, for this scenario negative. Now, what are the conditions under which the book cannot be issued? The book issue is having negative. Those are also jotted down. Those are also determined by the analyst after consulting the user, because when he will print or he will submit this thing to the development team, they need to prepare the software accordingly. They need to prepare the software such that these things should also be there in the entire software. So this is the scenario analysis concept. Another is the form analysis concept. So form analysis is definitely a requirement gathering analysis activity, requirement gathering activity that is undertaken by the analyst when the project involves automating of an existing manual system. So when such a scenario occurs that I already have a manual system existing, but I want this entire manual process or procedure to be automated by a software, then this form analysis concept will come. So during the operation of a manual system, what would have normally done? Several forms are required to be filled up by the stakeholders, right? So suppose, which I was talking about yesterday, bona fide certificate, what will happen? One stakeholder, suppose one student, he is a stakeholder, he will fill up, make the application for a bona fide certificate, he will submit it. The administrator will say that, yes, I have received, and I will be giving, he will give you a slip that I have received your application, you come and take it on next working day, right? Then the person will prepare the certificate, he will go to the principal, he will get it signed, he will entry this entire thing that which student has taken the certificate from which department on which month against which amount, he will note it down in his logbook, and then on the next working day when he will give this certificate to the student, he will take his signature on the receiving side that yes, he has received it. Because he may just take the certificate and then he can say that I have not received the certificate. So obviously he needs to give a recipient signature. So this is the procedure. So these are the forms which are distributed, which are taken, which are notifications are there. So in form analysis, what happens is the existing forms and the existing formats of these things that are produced, these are analyzed to determine the data that is input to the system and to determine the data that is output from the system. So the exact procedures, all the forms, all the notifications, these will be taken, this will be analyzed in order the analyst can gather information about the entire system that is existing manually. That is the data which is input to the system, the data which is output to the system. So for different sets of data input to the system, how this input data would be used by the system to produce the corresponding output data, this is determined. So scenario analysis takes place in places where we do not have a existing system, manually existing system already. Best possible way, it can take place where we have an existing system, it cannot take place also, but generally it is in those scenarios where we have to imagine the scenarios in which the respective functionalities can work and cannot work, those situations we have to conceptualize. And in form analysis, what happens? Physically, the analyst can get a few forms or applications or notifications about how this process is entirely going on. And after analyzing these documents, he can understand under which scenarios, what data is given to the system, how the system is processing, and what are the various output that is given out by the system. So these are the two ways how the analysis is being done. One is the scenario analysis, another is the form analysis. Is this thing clear? Yes or no? Is this entire?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So entire requirement gathering phase, it is clear, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now let us study about one case, one example. Okay, so I will just say this case study as a story to you. Just hear it, okay? Because it's not possible to write so many things. I will just go on saying the case. So let us understand one case study where the requirement gathering for the automation of the office work at the CSC department is needed. So suppose the financial information at the computer science and engineering department of a certain institute was carried out manually by two office clerks, a storekeeper, and two attendants. Okay, so four clerk people were appointed. They need to carry out this entire financial information, academic information, inventory information. So the department, they had a strength of about, suppose, 500 students in total of in all the 4 years, total was 500, and the teacher strength was 30. So 30 number of teachers are there, and approximately 500 students are there. So the HOD of that department, he wanted to automate the entire office work because these five people doing it was taking a lot of time. So he wanted to entirely automate the office work. Okay. Office work can be anything. Suppose after the result, one by one, the result of the marks of each candidate is taken, then the average is done. Then suppose result sheets are distributed, admit cards are distributed, who has taken card, who has not taken card, the database of users, all these things are done manually. So considering the low budget that this HOD has at his disposal, he gave this work to a team of student volunteers. Because he didn't have that much budget, he gave that I wanted to do an automated software of this official work at my department. I do not have that much fund. I will not go to an organization. I will use my fourth year students only to make this thing for my department. And in lieu of that, I will give them a few amount of money, which was possible from my side. Suppose 5,000, 6,000 rupees, I will give them. So for this requirements gathering, so in order to make this software, the first phase is requirement gathering. So for this requirements gathering, a member of that team was responsible for this requirement analysis and specification, which was briefed by the HOD about the specific activities which was needed to be automated. So the HOD will tell what are the activities which are needed to be automated, and a member from this development team he or she will gather all the information, he will perform this requirement gathering task, he will do the job of a system analyst. Okay, so the HOD, he mentioned three main aspects of the office work that needs to be automated. So he talked about three main parts of the office work that needs to be automated. One is the stores related activities. Another is the student grading activities. Another is the student leave management activities. Which student is going, I mean, is on leave, is not attending classes and all. Student leave management activities. So these three are the main activities which needed to be automated. So it was necessary for the analyst to meet the other categories of the users. So for student grading, student leave management, other categories of the users was also to be talked with. For stores related activities, the HOD has stated that he want this activity to be automated, but in order to understand the person who was associated with the stores, he need to brief the analyst so that the analyst can understand what are the works that were done under the stores related activities, right? So for the student leave management, definitely the analyst needs to talk with the students also, that what are they expecting from the, they are saying that I want a system that should be transparent. I am attending which classes so that at the end when I am receiving from the department that this is my attendance. So throughout the month, my which subject, for which subject I attended, which subject I not attended, everything should be visible for me so that I can see that, okay, fine, these are my leave dates. And also when I submit one leave form or I do a mail to the HOD also, then that thing should be updated. I want this thing from this feature. The HOD or the teachers may want some other things from the leave management thing, right? So the analyst, he needs to talk with the different categories of the user. So the HOD, he introduced the analyst to the office staff and to the students. Fine. So the analyst first discussed with the clerks regarding the specific responsibilities or tasks that they were required to automate it. So for the stores related activities, he will talk with the clerk who was doing this activity. For student grading activity, he will talk with the clerk who was doing this activity. For student leave management activity, he can talk with the clerk and the student also, those were attached with this activity, right? So for each task, they asked the clerks to brief them about the steps through which these activities are carried out. So the analyst will also inquire about the various scenarios that arise for each such task. And after the analyst has collected all types of information, all types of forms that were used by the student and the staff of the department, he can register various type of information or various type of services. Suppose for student leave management, the analyst needs to understand what is the format of the form which is circulated, what are the details that were there which the student needed to input. For student grading activity, he needs to understand what are the columns that the clerk fills, when is the result published, when not the result is published. So all this information they need to have, that is, which student has done the course registration, what is the course grading, what marks he has obtained from the last few years, from which departments I will get which marks. So all these things, that is departmental marks, internal marks is for departmental, non-departmental internal marks is given some other departmental teachers, how is a way to contact them. So all these informations he need to register, and the services which is there, that is suppose this stores related, suppose in the CSC department there are 5 registers for the attendance. Suppose 2 teachers are there, he has taken 2 registers, 3 registers are still in stock. So all these things also, that is how the items are issued from the store to the teachers, to the students, to the HODs, how they are issued. These things also, the forms, the details, the data, all these things he needs to have. So he will collect, that is he collected all the samples of various type of documents that the clerks were preparing. So some of these documents can be printed forms that the clerk filled up manually. Other may be some Excel, online Excel, suppose there is a spreadsheet, online Google spreadsheet, they were maintaining it there. Or suppose they are maintaining in the laptop or in the departmental computer, in the Excel form, some information are there. So for each inputs, they needed to see what are the different ways that they are doing. So they need to study the spreadsheets, they need to study the Excel forms, they need to study the printed forms, they need to study the applications. So they need to study each thing. And for each output that is occurring, the analyst will have to consult the clerks. That is how the entries are generated, how the entries are inputted, how they are knowing by seeing which input, which output, that this is the thing, this is the output. So they need to talk with the clerks, with the people who are in charge of these things. Solely by talking with the HOD, they won't be able to do the software, because HOD has just said that he wanted these 3 activities to be automated. But the actually the people who are involved in automating these activities or in doing these activities manually, they are in charge to tell these things to the analyst, and it's the analyst's responsibility to gather as much as information possible so that he can draw or he can have a complete picture of how the thing is going on. Okay, just wait a minute, just 1 minute. Okay. So the analyst, they will meet the storekeeper and he will inquire about the material issue procedure, the store ledger entry procedure, the procedure of how they are buying stuff from the people, how they are giving stuff to the teacher or the students. And he will also collect copies of all the relevant forms, information that are used by the storekeeper. And the analyst will also interview the student and the faculty representatives. Even in fact, they will not interview with 500 students, but they will interview with at least 10 students, representative of 2-3 students from each batch, right? Two boys from each batch, 2 girls from each batch. So that a representative of 10 students, they can at least say that what their batch wanted from this software. So he will talk with the interviewer, with the student representatives, he will talk with the faculty representatives, he will talk with the clerks, he will talk with the HODs. So in order to automate the existing activities of any working office, the analyst will obtain the exact formats of the input data, the output data, the description of the existing office procedures, and he will gather as much information possible by sitting or by talking or by seeing or by going through or by studying the materials available, the people who are attached with these activities. So this is the way how the requirements gathering phase for any automated software, for any software, be it a service, be it a product, by the client. Here the CSC department is the client, the HOD is the client. What the client is wanting and what the client wants, and those things, the people who were in charge of those things, how they are doing the procedures, they need to gather information. For that reason, they need to be in touch with each other so that as much information can be gathered. So is it now clear how this entire requirements gathering phase to a particular software, this entire phase is carried out? Is this thing clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any query? If you have any query about this requirement gathering phase, I just wanted to explain to you how, with the help of this example. Other projects will have other examples, some other activities they need to be automated. So if there is any query, you may ask. Okay. Next is the requirement gathering, and there was requirement analysis. So one phase was requirement gathering and analysis, another phase was requirement specification. So under this requirement gathering and analysis, I further divided it into requirement gathering and requirement analysis. So we have studied the requirement analysis. Now we will study the requirement gathering we have studied. Now we will study the requirement analysis phase. Now, after the requirement gathering is complete, the analyst, he will, 1 minute. So after the requirement gathering is complete, the analyst, he will analyze the gathered requirements. He will try to form an understanding of the exact customer requirements. He will try to cancel out any problems which are in the gathered requirements. He will try to cancel out any repeated information, any duplicate information, any not needed information. So the data which is collected from various stakeholders of that software, it can happen that the various data, they are in contradiction with each other, they are incomplete, there are ambiguities. So it may happen because everyone is not that much technically sound. Now he or she cannot say that this is the procedure, this is the exact thing. So it may contain some contradictions, it may contain some ambiguities, it may contain some incompleteness. So each stakeholder, they can only give a partial and incomplete view of the software. So it is the analyst's duty to study all the data which is gathered and to weed out all the problems, all the issues that are there in the gathered requirements. Therefore, it is definitely necessary to identify all the problems in the requirements gathering information and to resolve them with discussion with the customer. So the main purpose of the requirement analysis activities is to analyze So the main purpose of this requirement analysis is to analyze the gathered requirements in order to remove all the ambiguities, incompleteness, inconsistencies from the gathered customer requirements, and they need to obtain a clear understanding of the software which is to be developed, and they need to identify the problems in the requirements, and they need to resolve them through further discussion with the customer. So if I understand that these are the inconsistencies which are there in my information, I will talk with the customer and directly ask him that these are the incompleteness or these are inconsistency, can you clarify on this thing? If he or she can further clarify, then fine. If he or she cannot, then that thing will be resolved, that thing will be eliminated, we will weed out. So for carrying out this requirement analysis effectively, the analyst, he first needs to develop a clear grasp of the problem, and he needs to formulate some basic questions related to the project, which should be clearly understood by the analyst before carrying out this analysis. So he should formulate a few basic questions. Suppose he should have a clear knowledge. Suppose, what is the problem? Why is it important to solve the problem? Then what exactly are the data input to the system? What exactly are the data output from the system? What are the possible procedures that need to be followed in order to solve the problem? What are the complexities that might arise while solving the problem? If there are any external software or hardware with which the developed software has to be interfaced, then what should be the data interchange formats with the external systems? So all these things they need to ask, they need to understand, and after the analyst has understood the exact customer requirements, he will proceed to identify and resolve the various problems that he detects in the gathering phase. Okay, so what is the problem? Why is it important to solve the problem? What is the data input? What is the data output? What are the different possible procedures that need to be followed to solve the problem? What are the complexities that might arise in solving? What are the external software or hardware that are attached with or interfaced with this software that needs to be interfaced? What will be the format of the data interchange formats with the external system? So these all things he needs to be clear in order to identify and resolve the problems in the gathered requirements from the gathering phase. He needs to be clear in understanding all these things. Okay? Have you understood? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so okay. So everyone, please mark your attendance quickly. People who are being able to mark their attendance, they may leave the class because only 2 minutes are remaining. So now it is the time for taking the attendance. And if anyone has any query, he or she may ask me. Is there anyone who has not been able to mark their attendance? Is there anyone who has not been able to mark the attendance? Okay, then I will stop the share.